Swarna Bharat Trust at Nellore in Andhra Pradesh celebrated its 23rd anniversary on August 17, 2024. Vice President of India Jagdeep Dhankar was invited to mark the occasion as the chief guest. The Vice President, along with Dr. Sudhir Dhankar, were welcomed by the Governor of Andhra Pradesh, S. Abdul Nazir, Minister for Municipal Administration and Urban Development in the Government of Andhra Pradesh, Ponguru Narayana, the State's Minister of Endowments, Anam Ram Narayan Reddy, and other dignitaries on their arrival at Nellore. The Swarna Bharat Trust is a non-government organization which works to brighten India by giving support to rural people and students to get expertise in various fields. The Vice President's motorcade arrived at Akshara Vidyalaya campus, where he was welcomed by former Vice President of India M. Venkaiya Naidu, the chief mentor of the Swarna Bharat Trust. Naidu had envisioned the trust some 2.5 decades ago. It began functioning in 2001. The Akshara Vidyalaya is a part of the Swarna Bharat Trust. It aims to be an institution of excellence and to provide accessible, affordable and contemporary education with a deep-rooted value system, to provide a caring, stable environment and academic excellence while preparing its people for lifelong learning. All these facets were on display in Nellore during the Vice President's visit. The dignitaries paid floral tributes to Swami Vivekananda at Akshara Vidyalaya. The Vice President of India, along with other dignitaries, then proceeded towards the administration block of the Vidyalaya. At the entrance of the administration block, all the dignitaries paid tributes to the Iron Man of India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. The Swarna Bharat Trust offers skill development courses with a focus to provide better opportunities for poor and the marginalized. At the administrative block, children dressed as Lord Ram welcomed the dignitaries. In the background was a board that read, "Opening minds, medium is English, culture is Indian." This very much seemed to be the essence of the Vidyalaya. The Vice President made it a point to be captured on camera with the young kids. Slightly older students had prepared a traditional dance routine to welcome the Vice President, which was presented from the basketball court of the school. The Vice President, Jagdeep Dhankar, along with Dr. Sudhir Dhankar, waved to acknowledge the traditional welcome they received. The rendition of the bhajan, "Ram Ram Jai Raja Ram," was clearly touching an emotional chord in the Vice President. The ambience, enhanced by the presence of characters from the Ramayana, Ram, Sita, Lakshman and Hanuman, elevating the occasion to a whole new level. Within the Akshara Vidyalaya campus also lies the Soma Institute of Technical Training, the next stop for the Vice President. The Vice President keenly queried about the types of training imparted at the institute, which was duly explained by the former Vice President M. Venkaiya Naidu. The trainees at the institute had a photo op with the 13th and the 14th Vice Presidents of India. The motorcade then proceeded to the Swarna Bharat Trust complex. The Vice President visited a temple at the entrance of the complex. The priests chanted hymns. Saplings were planted and the Vice President also inquired about the text written in Telugu, signifying the beauty of India. a bouquet of flowers with different hues. A Center for Rural Development in the name of M. Venkaiah Naidu was inaugurated. The Vice President was shown around the place by the former Vice President himself. They took a golf cart to visit an exhibition at the campus. The Vice President took keen interest in some prosthetic items that were displayed at the exhibition. The dignitaries then took the golf cart ride for the main dice event at the Swarna Bharat Trust. After the national anthem, the dignitaries proceeded to light the lamp, marking the formal beginning of the main event, the 23rd anniversary celebration of the Swarna Bharat Trust. Former Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has always stressed upon strengthening the culture and keeping the national heritage intact. Inspired by this vision, the cultural program started with an invocation prayer offering to Lord Vitthala. This, apart from being a prayer, is also believed to be a good breathing exercise. The performance was staged by school dropout students who have been brought back to the mainstream by the Swarna Bharat Trust. The Vice President seemed to thoroughly enjoy the performances. The strong regional identity of Andhra Pradesh, seamlessly blending with India's unity and diversity, was beautifully showcased by the next invocation in the mother tongue, Telugu.
Mother tongue, Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Punjabi, Assami, Bhojpuri, Dogri, Kashmiri, any language. Beautiful. Because Bhasha aur Bhavana ek saath chalta hai.
Performed by the girl students of Swarna Bharati Vidya Mandir. The group included children of marginal farmers and orphans. The dignitaries were then invited on the dais. The former Vice President then talked about the gargantuan humane service provided by the Swarna Bharat Trust for more than 2 decades.
For the last 23 years, we have trained more than 1 lakh students, 1 lakh youngsters. That's a proud achievement. And the Swarna Bharat Trust do not take any support fund from the government. But they will work with the government and organize programs jointly. Secondly, Swarna Bharat Trust do not allow any political speeches to be made. They invite politicians, but political speech should be apolitical. And the third one is, the Swarna Bharat Trust inculcates Indian culture.
M. Venkaiah Naidu expressed satisfaction on the Vidyalaya, Vidya Mandir, Bridge School for Orphans, homes for the elderly, eye care centers and other medical facilities for the needy, along with the cultural activities the Swarna Bharat Trust is involved in.
Along with Swarna Bharat Trust, we have Akshara Vidyalaya. The Vice President Governor has just now seen it, visited that. And secondly, we have Swarna Bharat Vidya Mandir with 6,500 rupees per year, uniform, midday meals and education. Really a great service to the ordinary people of this region. And the third one is the Bridge School, taking care of the orphans and rural children who are abandoned by their parents or who are not having sufficient means to support themselves. They are brought here, trained here, given education and then admitted into government schools with the help of the district collector. This is how the trust is functioning. We have an elders home. Elders whose children are not here, they are brought here and they are taken care. And then we have LV Prasad Eye Care Center, rural people having first class eye care provided by LV Prasad, famous Hyderabad eye care center. They do 20 plus operations per day and treat more than 40-50 people. Then we have a regular hospital, Narayana, our minister's college is there, hospital also is here. And then we have dental clinic also taking care of the dental of the aged and rural people. All these are mostly free of cost unless somebody want to pay something and then support the trust activities.
Naidu also thanked the Vice President for gracing the occasion. The former Vice President then himself invited the serving Vice President to share his thoughts.
The present Vice President, I suggested to him to come over here. He readily agreed. In fact, he was asking me time and again, when should we go to Venkatachalam and Nellore Trust? Because of the construction of the building, I told him, please hold on for some time. We'll go at an appropriate time. But he was constantly inquiring. He was anxious to visit Swarnabhad Trust and then this Mupavar Foundation, started by my son, Harshavardhan, and then taken care by the family. I'm very thankful to the Vice President. I'm thankful to the Governor. And I would like to thank all the people who are participating in this function. And I would like to bless the small children who have played wonderfully the Pandari Bhajana of Pandurangi Vitala.
The Vice President began with deep admiration of his predecessor's commitment towards the welfare of the nation.
Most revered, highly respected, and the person from whom I learnt a lot, former Vice President Sri M. Venkaiah Naiduji. Friends, it is easy to emulate his principles and ideals, but difficult to get into his shoes. One of the leading personalities of Bharat, home to 1/6 of humanity, a life dedicated for welfare of the nation, unflinching commitment to ideals, and his heart is in rural India. And what I have seen today will ever be in my mind, both for motivation and inspiration. Right from the time I stepped on the premises, what I saw, civilization in action, concern for those who need hand-holding. Can you imagine an idea? A dropout being hand-held, skill being imparted. No wonder the man rightly had an idea 23 years ago, and that Swarnim Bharat Trust. उस भारत का सपना आज हम सबके सामने साकार हो रहा है. वेंकैया नायडू जी साधुवाद के पात्र हैं.
The Vice President said he had no words to express his gratitude towards Mr. Naidu and that he felt privileged to be invited to the place.
I am privileged to be part of that group that has put footfall in this place. Right from former prime ministers, present prime minister, presidents, governors, who not? One name more has been added, that of Jagdeep Dhankhar. A man from a village in Jhunjhunu who had seen all the difficult period. There were not many to handhold me. I find, sir, you are handholding those, changing their lives, bringing smile on their face. My congratulations. Swarnim Bharat Trust, in its 23rd year, gives an impression. It has been, it seems, decades and decades in existence. Shortly, I look forward to the Silver Jubilee celebration, and I am sure that will be befitting to the stature of Venkaiah Naidu ji and Swan Bhart Trust, and the journey will ever be incremental. Kya sapna dekha tha 23 saal pehle Swan Bhart ka, wo sapna hamare samne pura ho raha hai. और 2047 की यात्रा जो है, मैराथन मार्च है, उस मार्च में, उस महायज्ञ में यहां की आहुति भी बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है.
द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट देन टच्ड अपॉन द थीम ऑफ इकोनॉमिक नेशनलिज्म एंड अपील टू द कंट्रीमैन नॉट टू इंपोर्ट व्हाट कुड बी अवॉइडेड.
एवरी इंडियन मस्ट बिलीव इन इकोनॉमिक नेशनलिज्म. Economic nationalism is a facet of Swadeshi, is reflection of being vocal for local. Imagine if we believe in economic nationalism, we will have three immediate outcomes. Number one, we are importing items that are avoidable. We are importing items, carpets, garments, candles, kites, and what not, toys. In the process, our foreign exchange is going out. We are snatching hand from our workers. When we use an imported item, which can be made in this country, we are impeding our entrepreneurship. Because that item can be made by our entrepreneurs, by our workers. So my appeal to you is stop drain of foreign exchange for avoidable imports. Resolve it. Ultimately, consumer decides. But from this podium, I appeal industry, trade, commerce, they should take a call on this. That will give work to our people and blossom entrepreneurship.
India is a country with around 2.4% of the world's land mass, but nearly 17.8% of the world's population. Need-based consumption in the country has to be always emphasized and stressed upon.
Another serious issue. Natural resources, we must have optimal consumption. We must use petrol not on the strength of our pocket, not on the strength of our economic power, but on the strength of our need. All natural resources in any form must be used optimally. यदि अगर पैसे की ताकत ये तय करेगी और हम बेतहाशा खर्चा करेंगे, हम आने वाली पीढ़ी को संकट में डाल रहे हैं. उसी तरीके से जो मैंने पहले कहा, आर्थिक फायदे के लिए देश की अर्थव्यवस्था को किसी भी तरीके से कमजोर करना बुद्धिमता नहीं है. We will have to have a culture. We will always have to keep nation first. We will have to keep nation above political interest, above self-interest, above economic interest. And I have no doubt that this will be brought about. Second, और जिसकी ओर मैं खास ध्यान आकर्षित करना चाहता हूं, our country abounds in natural resources, but it is very painful when we export raw material. Look at the ports. Our iron ore is going. We don't add value to it. In the process, we damage employment potential. Some people only to make easy money, quick money, don't add value to it. As a nation, we cannot afford it. I am sure enough attention will be given to one and all issues.
The Vice President concluded by congratulating the Swarna Bharat Trust once again and wished it blossomed more in the future.
This can be an epicenter of change. It can trigger a big change in the country. And I have no doubt I may formally not be a member of this trust, but I am its foot soldier. I am its foot soldier because the trust is realizing preamble of Indian Constitution. Aaj ke din aavashyakta hai zameen par karkar dikhana. Wo karkar dikhana jo aam aadmi ki zindagi mein badlav laaye. Us vyakti ki zameen mein zameeni haqeeqat mein badlav laaye jise ummeed chhod di hai. I wish the trust a great success. I wish the trust something amazing. और मुझे पता है जब भारत अपनी आजादी की शताब्दी मना रहा होगा, विकसित भारत के रूप में उसी समय उसके दो साल बाद ये ट्रस्ट भी अपनी गोल्डन जुबली मना रहा होगा. सम ऑफ अस में नॉट बी अराउंड बट इट विल बी नंबर वन इन द कंट्री, आई नो डाउट अबाउट इट. अंत में लेट मी कंक्लूड with an inspirational words of wisdom from Rig Veda. Sangach dhvai, saundhvai dhvai, let us move together, let us speak in one voice, and I add, let us always speak for the nation. Let us always keep nation above everything else. Some people in the country, for reasons which are not appropriate, have put their political interest above national interest. Let us hope and pray they get wiser, they get counsel from those sacrifices, supreme sacrifices, which were made for this freedom, which has to be nurtured every moment so that it can blossom.
The Vice President then released the book Venkaiah Naidu, A Statesman, a pictorial biography of the 13th Vice President of India, M. Venkaiah Naidu, authored by Sanjay Kishore. The Vice President Jagdeep Dhankar and Dr. Sudesh Dhankar also received mementos. The function concluded with another photo op. After a traditional lunch, the Vice President proceeded towards the helipad before emplaning for his return journey. The Vice President was presented a wooden statue of Lord Venkateshwara, concluding a trip deeply embedded in the cultural ethos of the land.
More programs of Sansad TV, subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to like and share them.